Hello everyone. In continuation of the last session, we were discussing in the judicial process the concept of law with dharma. When we were not having law or our constitution or acts or provisions were not there, that time the society, how the societal order used to get maintained. In those era, the societal life used to get maintained by the dharma, the restriction of dharma. Each and every individual used to follow a particular kind of faith, but it is, as I have discussed already, it is only one element. As we can say, religion, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, these are considered as different religion. But religion was only one element. It was with other element like culture, faith, rituals. These are the different elements. And those are related to different kind of moralities. And we can say that dharma was very much rigid and which used to restrict the human behavior in strict manner. Generally we say that, and it is also sure that dharma cannot change. Law can change with the need of the society, but dharma is something which never changes. And that is why it is in strict nature. And that is why change is nature of life. But dharma does not changes. It changes all around with keeping the basics unchanged. The concept is dharma does not get changed. But dharma has tendency to keep basic unchanged. As we discuss currently, if with the example of current example, like as we discuss, we can change or we can amend the constitution, but by keeping the concept of basic structure intact, we can alter and we can amend the constitution. Similarly, the concept of dharma, what is right, what is moral, what is wrong, everything was fixed, so it cannot change. But it used to change gradually, only in the form of by keeping their basic concept intacted. They used to alter little bit, but they cannot, dharma cannot change entirely. Moreover to it, we can see that it differs like individual to individual. There are different people following different religion. On the base of their different religion or on the base of different faith, something can be moral for some individual, but something can be immoral for other individual. For example, we can say particular religion, in Jainism, some food is restricted. They don't have onion or garlic in their foods. But in other caste or in other religion, that is not there. So we generally use other all type of food. So this is the habit or this is the morality. In Jainism that is wrong, but in Hinduism something is not wrong. It depends and it differs religion to religion, individual to individual, person to person. Likewise, even if we see, it changes place to place. Morality also get changed place to place. In some country something is moral, but it will be immoral in other country, in other place. So morality changes individual to individual, place to place, even time to time. If we see to it that, like some practices which are currently, they are approved, but they were disapproved 10 years back. For example, we can say some practices if recently we see that live-in relationship, the concept of live-in relationship, which is acceptable in current scenario, which is acceptable in, we can say, in year 2020, but it was not there 10 years back. Even if this concept of live-in relationship is not legalized in nature, because we are not having any particular act to support it, but we can see and we can adapt it in different forms. Like we can see that the many people go ahead with the live-in relationship kind of agreement. So they are getting into the kind of agreement with all details, with clearing all terms and conditions of living period, sharing accommodation, sharing finances, sharing whatever if the child is there, sharing the responsibilities, everything. So that is that, in that form it is a kind of moral we have accepted, but it is not thoroughly legalized. Even if we have seen that Domestic Violence Act 2005, in Domestic Violence Act 2005, even they have incorporated women living in live-in relationship, and they are protecting that woman against domestic violence. The second correction in or second amendment in the CRPC code 1973 that has been made in 2000 by the Melimuth committee, and Melimuth committee has suggested and revised the definition of wife in terms that so that the woman who is living in the live-in relationship, even she can avail the maintenance under section 125. So these are the correction, these are the updation. There was one case in 2015, Dhanulal versus Dhanulal versus Ganesh Ram, in which they have given the landmark judgment and said that even the woman who is living in the relationship for the longer period or longer tenure, she will be able to ask for a right in inherited property too. And even her child also will get right of property in the paternal inheritance. So this is how we can say that the concept of live-in relationship we cannot accept in Indian culture. If we talk about Indian culture of 10 or 20 years back, but now in current scenario we are gradually accepting the change. So this is how the concept of law changes, and law tries to accommodate new challenges and new changes of society. So actually the concept is law and society goes hand in hand. There are strict guidelines, strict lines under which law tries to drive the society, but in some specific point in time when law realized that society is upgraded and now society needs new boundaries, in that case law tries to amend, law tries to accommodate new challenges and new necessities of society in the limits of the law. So this is how law and society works hand in hand and goes hand in hand. And judiciary plays an important role in maintaining all this thing together. And this is the basic concept of judiciary, how judiciary plays important role. Judiciary plays important role by making judgment laws, by correcting, by giving different new guidelines for the society so that they can follow it and they can go into the right direction. So to maintain the faith of the common man in the judiciary, it is very much important for the judiciary to give speedy justice, to give impartially an unbiased judgment. And by this only judiciary can in judiciary common man can keep faith, and then only our society can get driven in proper way. So this is how judicial process and judges plays an important role in maintaining social order. So now when we start looking into the form, how we can say that judicial process is an important instrument. So as we discussed, under Article 32 and Article 226, judiciary has given a extra power, even in form of judicial review. So by this all kind of instruments, whenever somebody is asking and filing a petition, writ petition in the Supreme Court, judges can listen to it properly and then give justice as per the requirement and on the basis of the matter. So this is how, by giving right direction, by giving right decision, judges can play an important role in following social ordering. There are two types of judicial process generally acceptable in society: adversarial judicial system and inquisitorial judicial system. Adversarial judicial system is generally we follow in India, where two different advocates of two different parties, they comes in, they discuss, they argue on the matter, and on the basis of their argument and produce evidence, judge's role is to check it properly, and they perform the job of referee in that case, and they decide on the basis of argument and on the basis of provided evidences who is right and who is wrong. That is a kind of system, we can say that adversarial judicial system. Inquisitorial judicial system is little bit different, in which court himself, judge himself, or the authority or body of the court, they plays an important role. They go in detail of each and everything, and they strive to find what is right and what is wrong actually. They don't only rely upon the evidences provided by the advocates or the argument done by the advocates, but they actually go into detail, they cross-examine, they do surveys and everything, and they find out what is truth. So that is a kind of inquisitorial system. So in India, we majorly follow adversarial judicial system. So if it is been followed, instead of adversarial, if inquisitorial system is followed, in that case, we can see, we can get more, a better form of decision in terms of social ordering. Then also, till now also, we are getting so many good decisions, and the decisions which are seems to be a torchbearer for our progressive society. So now we will be discussing a few cases and case laws by which we can say that how social ordering occurs in the form of with the tool of judicial process. And that we will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you.